So the central bank deputy governor says the country's debt is manageable and there's just not much to worry about. Of course, there has been all these alarms that we need to backtrack a bit on how much we are borrowing as a country. But the deputy governor says there's no need to worry. Everything is under control. The question is just how long that will be, because we know for a fact that our appetite as a country to borrow has been really on the high. Almost every time you hear the ministers before committees asking for supplementary budgets, and before you realize there is some money to be borrowed from somewhere to be handled or to be transferred to some other department, I tell you what, the locals, I mean the manufacturers and the business community here, will tell you that they need prioritization, and government needs to know that if they are borrowing, it must be for the right cause. That was during a conversation recently down in Kampala, where the deputy governor was speaking to different manufacturers and a business community in the country. My name is Simon. Thank you so much for joining us on The Business Show this week. From wherever you're watching, we are glad you could make time. This is what is coming up on the show this week.
You need to be tech savvy, yeah? You need to be familiar with technology, okay? It's a gradual thing. It's a gradual process. You have to learn a few things, okay? I've seen people come up, get numbers. Some have bought followers, what you call bots. You having numbers doesn't make you an influencer.
Once again, welcome to the show. And this week we'll talk about possibilities of making easy how to access service providers. Now, how many times did you ever imagine that you could sit back and at a click of a button, you can get a plumber, you can get a videographer, you can get a photographer, or better still, you can get the different services on one platform. Now, that is what Impartial World is doing. During COVID, actually from 2019 is when this started, and it has been tremendous for them because even post-COVID, it is working. And like we've said, it's now the new normal. Most people have adapted to working online and looking for services online. So as a result, this is working for them. This week on Views from the Top, we speak to Rita and Herbert, who are the guys behind this down at Impartial World at Innovation Village, who tell us how this is operating and the conversation around cashless economy. Just how realistic is it? Views from the Top.
My name is Matop Brian Herbert. I am the Legal and Administration Manager, Impartial World. Impartial World is a Ugandan made app that focuses on providing service providers with a platform where they can provide their services and also conveniently bringing access to the service seekers. So from a distant place, a person whom we refer to as a client at Impartial World is able to search for a given service provider, for example, a lawyer, and then is able to link up with that lawyer, and the lawyer is able to provide the service and able to also receive the payment through Impartial World. So what we do is we are aiming at providing convenience to the clients. I remember of a friend who had a challenge one time and he basically needed to access a lawyer for some legal advice. But this particular friend didn't know any law firm around town and didn't even have any friend who is a lawyer or who could even connect him to a lawyer. So he found himself in a challenge. And by then we didn't have the Impartial World app. So the journey began from there, and the directors of this virtual organization said, how best can we provide convenient access to service providers? And the best way was to come up with Impartial World app. I started with legal services because basically we began as a legal services provider. Then we went into other services. So we have a variety of services. We have engineers, we have teachers, we have accountants, we have plumbers, we have carpenters, all these providing various kinds of services. Yes. So you can be in a location and you need a plumber, say you're in Nigeria, but you don't have any contact of a plumber, you need somebody to attend to your sewage. So instead of calling friends around to find you a plumber, you can simply go onto the Impashwali app and it will be able to provide you a list of plumbers within that particular location. So the app has been around for some time, but we began operations, active operations in 2019. So we have been running actively. And what inspired us to open up to other service providers was we began with legal services, and as we're in the market selling out this particular product, the clients we interacted with kept on inquiring, how about me, a teacher? Can't I come onto this app and also provide my services as a teacher? Also, the clients who were searching out for the legal services, they would come out and say, what if you include other services? Do you only concentrate on legal services? So we sat back and thought about it and said, no, we should give a variety of services to the people who are seeking for them. And that's how we opened up and catered for each and every particular service provider and every particular service seeker. That you don't need to have multiple applications on your phone. You have an app for doctors, you have an app for lawyers, you have an app for mechanics, you have an app for carpenters. So to bridge that gap, we had to just come up with one particular app that has each and every particular services that a person may be seeking out for. Just get into your Google Play Store or App Store, download the app, install it on your phone, and then if you are seeking for a service that is a client, you set up your profile as a client and you'll be able to access a variety of the service providers on the platform. If you're interested in any, you simply click on that particular service provider or service you're interested in, and then you can make an order. As simple as that, the provider will be able to receive a notification that he has received an order from a particular client and will be able to either accept the order or reject it. If he accepts the order, definitely the provider will begin performing the service, or he will come to your station and provide the service that you have asked for. After providing the service and you are satisfied, the provider is going to ask you to release payment, and the client will be able to release payment on the app, and the provider will be able to receive his or her payment on his wallet. Well, for the service providers, the process is also very simple. They also download and install the application on their phones, and then they are able to set up their profiles. For the service providers, because we are looking at quality assurance, we need them to upload licenses. If he's a lawyer, he will have to upload a practicing certificate to prove that he's providing that particular service. If he's a doctor, same thing, he will have to upload a practicing certificate. For blue collars like plumbers, mechanics, we always require them to upload at least a license from KCCA or a license from their particular town councils where they are operating from, for us to prove that whatever we are uploading on this particular application is genuine. So we don't want to have a variety of quick service providers who are simply coming on board and then they are saying, I am a teacher, but he doesn't have any qualifications in education, or he's a lawyer and he doesn't have any minimum required qualifications for him to practice law. So that's why we put that measure that as a provider, you need to upload a particular license for you to be approved. So as soon as you upload the license and we have verified, we shall approve your account and you'll be able to go online. So you'll be online and the client will be able to access your account or your service, and they'll be able to make orders to you.
My name is Rita Nabalwanyi and I'm operations manager in Pasho World. Well, you see, the challenge is most people are still laid back in the old systems of doing things. Let's say paying through the app. There is a time where I was supposed to pay a border person. He had delivered branded material and I was supposed to receive them. So when I told him to edit his profile and all, he's like, you see, I fear this money. I don't like the way money moves in the air. So that he's not comfortable with that. So it also brought me back to other people, how they look at this. They are not well informed about how money moves through the digital system, technology-wise. Yeah, so people are still not trusting the kind of the process of how transactions are made through the app. And yeah, well, you see, it is very convenient. Just imagine you're stuck somewhere, you're in your house, and you really want, you want a salonist, someone to cut your hair, and you do not want to move. You just a matter of getting your phone and going to the app. It is very convenient. That is what I'm trying to bring forward. It is very convenient, and the transaction way is very easy. It is very easy to transact, very instant, very fast. And it is very informative. Before you look around all the services that you want to choose, there is information that will help you choose that very service that will make you comfortable with whatever choice that you have made. So, you know, it is the first of its kind. In Uganda, there is no app like this one. I haven't seen an app which connects service providers to clients. I haven't seen that. And then also, you might have had so many startups that are not well known, startups that do not have the money to advertise their products, their services, but we offer them a free platform to do this. So that's what makes us unique. There is no other app like this that connects service providers to clients. And then also we help them grow their businesses free of charge. We do not charge them advertising costs, because these are the adverts that we are going to put on our app, on our website, and on our social media pages. And, the challenge is still someone would prefer to walk in a shop instead of using the app. People are not well versed with technology very well. They are not trusting to the technology. Most people really would find convenience. People would buy convenience instead. At the end of the day, this is where we're all moving from the old way of doing things to going digital. So I believe it's a very good product. And another thing, the fact that we really connect service providers to their clients, it's something that a service provider would want to associate with. So they really are welcoming to that as service providers. Well, they have to make their apps, whatever they're innovating, they have to make it very trusting. They have to give a client a reason as to why they should. They should also, like how we do it, we have these mini statements on our apps. Like if you say you make a transaction, there are all those receipts, everything. Like there is nothing that, everything is very transparent. You see how your money is moving, you see. So they have to make it very, very transparent for clients to trust them, very trusting and transparent. Well, my experience, first of all, remember we were locked down, we're not allowed to move. There is a time where we're not allowed to move. But then you need services. And I used to have money on my phone, on my bank account. I can't even spend it, but I need a service. I need a product. But now here comes a product like this in Pasho World. See how it makes life easy. It's I need someone to do my hair. I'll just get on the app and order for that service. So yeah, it is very convenient in that regard, and it comes in handy for such a time like this. Just imagine you're there stuck, you're paying rent, but no one knows even that you exist. But just imagine you put your service on the app. Everyone, wherever they are, different places, wherever they are, they will know that there is a certain someone who has this service and I need it. So they will come to you. So it is very helpful in that regard, mostly for the service providers. Yeah, it is something really that we should also focus on. I think, thank you for that, because also like I will also bring it up in one of those meetings. It is very, very helpful because not everyone really can access internet, I mean, can afford internet. So it's something that we're really also looking forward to adjust in our way of our operations and produce that USSD code that doesn't need internet for someone also to easily access our services. For now, I'll tell the viewers to get away from the old ways of doing things, to get on the app. It is very easy, very accessible, and it gives you all whatever you need at your preference of price. So I advise them to download the Impartial World app. Yes, and let's grow together, especially the startups. I would advise them mostly so that they get well known and they're advertised out there at a free cost.
So there's been all these talks about cashless economy. The question is, at what point will Ugandans ever understand that there is a possibility of transferring money without handling the actual cash? Of course, you know the fact that there's issues of security and all that, but like Rita says, we need to maybe take a back step and just think again as a country and know that it is where we are heading, because cashless economies is what is probably running globally. So as a country, we need to backtrack, take another step and go again and know that these platforms are here to stay. So with Impartial World there, you know now, you can take a click of a button, just have the app on your phone and you can have all these services. You don't need to run through this traffic to get the services. As a business person, time is key. So if you can cut down on the costs and still get the services, good to go. You're watching The Show with me, Simon. Let's take a quick break. Stay with us. In the meantime, feel free to get in touch with us. Drop us those comments. I'll see you shortly.